Hello students, in this video we will learn about noun. That what are nouns? Meaning, a noun is a word used to name a person, animal, place, thing and abstract idea. Nouns are usually the first word which small children learn. Mean student, noun aise word hote hain जो हमें पर्सन, एनिमल, प्लेस, थिंग और एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया के बारे में बताते हैं. बच्चों, जो नाउन है वो ऐसा फर्स्ट वर्ड है, ऐसा ग्रामर का पहला टॉपिक है जो बच्चे छोटी छोटी क्लास से ही पढ़ना शुरू कर देते हैं. अब बच्चों, आप ये सोच रहे होगे कि एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया क्या होता है. स्टूडेंट, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया होता है जब हम कोई अपना इमोशन, जिसे हम सिर्फ फील कर सकते हैं बट टच नहीं कर सकते, जब हम ऐसे वर्ड्स की बात करते हैं तो जो उन वर्ड्स को हम एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया के नाम से डिनोट करते हैं. अब मैं आपको एक एग्जांपल देती हूँ. हैप्पीनेस, एज यू नो डैट वी कैन ओनली फील द हैप्पीनेस, है ना. हम हैप्पीनेस को सिर्फ फील कर सकते हैं, वी कैन नॉट टच इट. हम उसको टच कर सकते हैं हैप्पीनेस को? नहीं ना. तो ऐसे वर्ड्स होते हैं बच्चों एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया. इन शॉर्ट, व्हाट वी कैन सी, फील और थिंक इज कॉल्ड नाउन. स्टूडेंट, इफ वी आस्क अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ नाउन इन शॉर्ट टर्म्स, देन वी कैन सी दैट noun are the words which we can see, feel or think. For example, we can see. If we talk about the example on the basis of see, then you can see a boy, a table, a tree. As you can see all these three things, so these are the examples of noun which we can see. For example, we can feel. If we talk about the feeling, then the examples are happiness, anger, taste. Mean students, these all the three terms we can only feel, we cannot touch it. Okay, so these all three are nouns which we can feel. As we can think, fantasy, psychology, these are the words which are known as noun, but this word we can think. So students, these are some of the nouns which I given to you. Let's read. Art, tiger, tea, scarf, bat, teeth, wig, parrot, basket, tub, truck, park, beer, hands, cellulars, jug, clothes, wrist, wall, knee, chalk, file, ice, juice, cheese, female, Indian, lady. So students, these all are the examples of nouns. Now, let us read further. Noun can be singular or plural. When you are talking about one person, animal, place or thing, use a singular noun. Students, if we talk about the noun, then noun can be in the form of singular or in the form of plural. But when we talk about the singular noun means when we talk about one person, one animal, one place or one thing, then it should be known as singular noun. Then we have to use the words like a woman, a ship, an owl, a train, a flower. As you can see, woman is used in the singular noun. Okay, so these all are the words which are used in the form of singular noun. When you are talking about two or more people, animal, places or things, use plural noun. Students, whenever we talk about two or more people, animal, place or thing, at that point of time we have to use plural noun. Most nouns are made plural by adding s at the end. If we want to change singular noun into plural noun, at that point of time we have to add s at the end. As you can see in this example, bat become bats because bat shows that it is in singular noun and bat shows that it is in plural noun. The second example, see, mug becomes mugs, star becomes stars, fan becomes fans, cap becomes caps. Okay, so by this way we can change singular noun into the plural noun. Now some of the words given, let's see. Singular, in singular, bird become birds. While whenever we change the singular into plural, what we have to do? Yes, we have to add s at the end of the singular noun. So bird become birds, broom become brooms, camel become camels, desk become decks, doll become dolls, egg become eggs, flower become flowers, fog become fogs, game become games, lamp become lamps, nest become nests, pen become pens, photo becomes photos, shirt becomes shirts. Okay, so by adding s at the end of singular noun, we can easily change it into plural noun. Now we will learn about the types of noun. There are mostly two types of noun, proper noun and the common noun. First of all, we will talk about the proper noun. That what are proper noun? They are the names of a particular place, people or things. They are usually unique. There is only one. Means students, whenever we will talk about the proper noun, then we have to talk about a particular name of a people or a place or a thing. Means the name is the unique one. No other person, place or thing have the same name. At that point of time, we can say that this is the proper noun. As you can see, the examples are given below. If we talk about the name of a person like Nita, Shyam, etc., these are the proper noun because no other person have the same name like Nita, Shyam, etc. The second one is place. When we talk about the place like Jamnagar, Rajkot, Vadodara, etc., these are some specific places. These are some specific name given to the places. No other place is given the same name. Such type of noun are known as proper noun. The third one, as you can see, the name of the month like January, February, October, right? So the different month give the different names. No month have the same name like of the other month. So such type of names are also known as proper nouns. See the fourth one, name of the week like Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So every day have its own name, right? No special name is given to the other day. So such type of noun is also known as proper noun. See the name of the festival, Diwali, Holi, Christmas, Dashera, etc. These are the examples of proper noun. Because no one festival name is given to the other festival, right? Every festival have its own specific name and special name. So such type of words are also known as proper noun. Come to the language, right? There are different type of language and every language has its own name like Hindi, English, Gujarati, Marathi, etc. So such type of words are also known as proper noun. Come to the next one. Name of the country, American, Indian, Russian, Australian, right? So these are the country's name. So every country have its own name, specific name, and such type of names are known as proper noun. And the last one is name of seasons like winter, rainy, summer, etc. So every season have its own name. No one season name is given on the basis of the other season. So such type of words are also known as proper noun. So I hope you understand what are proper noun. Proper noun are the nouns or the names of a particular people, place or thing. Now let us discuss about the common noun. Common noun, they refers to people, place and things, but not by their individual name. For example, India is a common noun, but country is a proper noun. So students, we can see that in this example, India is a common noun, right? India is a common noun, but country is a proper noun. No, in this example it's wrong. Because India is a proper noun, because no one country has the name India, right? India has its own name. But country, every country is known as country. So it is a proper noun. It is a general name, right? So we can say that country is a common noun and India is a proper noun. Okay? So I hope you understand what are common noun. Common nouns refers to people, place or thing by their general name. No one have their individual name. Examples are given: love, education, time, jogging, working, farming, math, history, bread, chocolate, fish, air, oxygen, steam, tea, milk, gasoline, wood, plastic, silk, cold, electricity, weather, soil, sand, sugar, salt. So these are the examples of common noun. Means these names are on the general basis. No one name is given on their individual names. So such type of words are known as common nouns. So students, in this video, we have learned about the nouns and its type. And I hope the topic of noun and its type is clear to you. And if you have any doubt, then you can easily see this video for 2 to 3 times so that every doubt is clear to you and you can easily solve your worksheets. And then also, if your doubts are not clear, then you can ask me at any time. So, students, till then, goodbye and take care.